Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our third annual Malaysian and Singaporean Culture Night. I'm Siva.
And I'm Helen, and we are your hosts for tonight.
So you've just seen a video, a behind-the-scenes video, of our cast and crew who have been working hard for months to put on tonight's event.
Culture Night, since its inception in 2015, has been a way for Singaporeans and Malaysians to meet each other and to create something special for you and for the rest of the UCLA community.
None of this would have been possible without our wonderful sponsors, the Campus Programs Committee, the Arts Restoration Community Fund, ASUCLA, USAC, and the Overseas Singaporean Unit. On behalf of the cast and crew, we would like to thank you, our wonderful sponsors, to make this show a reality.
And of course, we'd like to thank you, our audience, for coming here to support us, because you are the reason why we continue Culture Night every single year.
Hey, Helen, what's up with the title of this show, La La Land? The original movie has nothing to do with Malaysia or Singapore. And as far as I know, I'm pretty sure that Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone aren't here tonight. Unless there's something they're not telling me.
Well, if you have noticed, we spelled La a little bit differently from the original. The La that we use is a common feature of Singlish and Manglish, which is a Creole of English that we use in Singapore and Malaysia. So by changing the title just a little bit, we are creating our own spin on the idea of La La Land.
Oh, so just like in the movie, how the characters were trying to navigate LA, in this show, the characters are trying to find their place in this unfamiliar city, but with a Malaysian and Singaporean twist.
Yes, and you can also expect there to be plenty of dancing and singing, just like in the movie, but with Singapore and Malaysian twist.
Huh. Well, hey, do you know what else that we have in common with the movie La La Land?
What?
Well, we have won the same amount of Best Picture Oscars. Oh.
So I bet you're all very excited now. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Presenting this year's Malaysian Singaporean Culture Night, La La Land.
Class, do you mind handing this out to your classmates, please? Thank you. Now, it's only the third day of the quarter, but this actually means that you guys have your first midterm drafts due next week.
What class is this again?
Incom 3! How would you come to class without knowing what class this is?
Sorry man, got pretty late last night.
Excuse me, the three of you. Would you like to take your conversation outside?
No, sorry.
Good. Then I appreciate your silence. Now, in the previous lecture, we started discussing a little bit about rhetoric and literature, and would like to continue that today by having one of you read the article that I just handed out. So, any volunteers? All right, whoever does it gets bonus participation points.
Ooh, take me, take me.
Okay, how about you, Kevin?
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Go ahead.
With the educative powers of classical and English literature, as well as the appeal of popular choice and education, by the 19th century, many were not merely literary, but vigorously literary. In fact, many well.
Alright, thanks Kevin. Now I'd like you guys to take out a piece of paper and write down what you think about the article that Kevin just read. You that's a wrap for class today. Make sure to do your readings, and I'll see you guys next week.
Oh, hey, I'm Kevin.
Oh, hi, I'm Samantha. You can call me Sam.
Cool. Do you happen to be in Math 32A with Chase? I think I saw you there.
Yeah, the class is huge, eh? I can't believe you noticed me.
Yeah, it's really tough too. I don't know if I'll survive till the end of the quarter. Anyways, you want to work on homework one together?
可以，不累. I mean, sure.
In that case, do you mind if we exchange phone numbers so I can arrange a study session?
Yeah, can.
Okay, I gotta head off to my next class. I'll text you.
Okay.
See ya.
Bye. Oh crap. What did I get myself into, man? He's so perfect. That voice, that smile, that accent. And me, I'm so taller. I know. I asked my roommates for help.
So, week one is over. Wow, I never thought college would be too much stuff happening all at once. Classes aren't too bad lah, although that 32A with that SL professor is gonna be GG. I heard shit gets real around week three. Gotta get ready, I guess. I know it's only been a week, but I already miss home. Staying through after orientation was rough. I really miss my family, my friends, and definitely the food. The food. But home is 15,000 kilometers away, in Singapore. And come on, I'm in LA. I shouldn't miss home that much. Home is where everything moves so fast. Everyone demands results, and life gets mapped out by norms and expectations.
When you grow up, you're going to be a doctor.
What's the word? Hella. Hella judged for stepping out of line. Even here in LA, I'm finding it so hard to just be open about myself. I don't know. I guess I just need to get used to being comfortable about it. It's the 21st century and people are becoming more open-minded, but my family, my relatives, even some of my friends back home can't seem to accept that. And I've been living under a mask for so long now. Maybe this will be my chance to be myself openly and to find out what it means to be free. I've already made lots of friends and we've had some great times, but I've yet to sit down with my multicultural group of friends on a patch of green grass yet. But the social life here is definitely more happening than at home. Who knows? I might actually find someone. The one. Here.
Hey, Sam, what you doing?
Oh, hey, nothing much. Just some homework. What's up?
Yeah, right. Anyway, we promised to do the physics problem set together. And I'm still stuck on question one.
Come on, man, you gotta help me. Come on. All right, I'm coming. Oh, let's go.
What's macam yes?
It's like pretending to know something that you don't, or trying to be someone that you're not.
See, Sam, this is what I was telling you about. How come you've only been here for as long as me, but your accent is already so good?
Hey, what's going on?
Well, Sam has been having guys' problems, so she liked this guy, but think he's too cool for her.
Sam, girl, I told you, you don't have to try so hard to impress this guy.
But he's American. Maybe he'll find me too unfamiliar. You and Jenny both have American boyfriends, wow. Why can't I?
American, international, green card, does it really matter? Why can't he? Honey? Honey?
Yes, yes, no, yes, you know, whatever she said, I agree.
See? Not like having an American boyfriend that great also.
Hey, what?
I'm just joking, chill.
Wait, so you're trying to impress this American guy, and you want me to do what?
Teach me how to be more American, so I can get that boy.
Wait, why didn't you ask Crystal or Jenny? Or Tom and Greg? They're American.
Oh. I don't know how to say this, but I don't think they're as cool as you.
Whoa!
Hey, guys, look at him, his hair got like lilac blonde thing going on. And anyway, I need you all to help me. I can't do this on my own. I just thought maybe Sam should take the lead.
Wait, but I think Crystal was right earlier. You shouldn't have to try so hard to impress this guy. I mean, acting American? Won't that make you be macam yes?
But maybe I'm not good enough, leh.
No.
See? I can't face it the way I am. It was so awkward the other day in class, you know? And I know there's nothing wrong with my accent. It's just who I am, it's where I come from, blah, blah, blah. But maybe if I try to fake an accent, he'll be like more open to me. And then when we get to know each other better, I can gradually show him my real self and accent. I mean, what could go wrong, right? So you help me, right? Please?
Okay, I still think this is a really bad idea, but since you asked. Whenever I see someone less fabulous than me, and let's face it, who isn't less fabulous than me? Before that, I have a little something for you that will make you more American instantly. You ready?
Okay. Ken.
Voila. You look
50% more American. All right, so I think we'll start with your accent. Is that okay?
Okay,
so let's start with, okay, let's repeat after me.
Okay.
Water.
Water.
Okay, let me be more specific. Maybe lighten up on the T and then roll your R's. Okay. Like that, I guess. Let's try it again. Water.
Water.
There's nothing wrong with the Malaysian accent. Honestly, I mean.
Sam, please, you say you help me, love, please, love.
Okay. We'll work on your accent a little bit, a lot more. And maybe a change of wardrobe wouldn't hurt either.
Yeah, thank you so much, Sam.
Thank
you.
Now that we've started, I think you mean thank you very much, Sam.
Hiya. Guess I got a lot of work to do, huh?
Come on.
Oh, hi, Sam.
Hey, have you guys finished the reading Dr. Lisa asked us to do?
Oh my god, I forgot to do the reading.
But don't we have to write a paper about it later?
Hey guys, what if we all don't do the reading? It's practically half the class. She can't cut all our marks, right?
But she'll be so upset. I don't think she mind failing us all. There are professors like that, you know?
Dude, what class are we talking about here?
Incom 3!
Oh, what was the reading again?
Dude, are you ever sober?
Hey, what's wrong with living life while always being late?
You know what? You guys can go ahead and fail the class. I'm going to do my readings right now.
Oh my god, you can't do that to us. If you do the reading, all of us is gonna look back. Don't be that girl who messes up the curve.
Girl? Did you just assume my gender?
Sorry, sir. What's your preferred gender pronouns?
She, her, hers, but I prefer to be asked.
Hey, guys. I think she's right, you know. Look at those two over there. They have probably finished their reading and are doing their essay right now.
Hey, Kevin. How's the problem set so far?
It's okay.
So far, I think section B is kind of tricky, though.
Oh my gosh, I got you. Would you like to help me with problem B too? I'm like totally lost.
Actually I know exactly how to do this.
It's really simple. All you have to do is to find the difference between the parametric equations and then solve for the derivative.
Wrong. He's so clueless.
Are you sure? I thought Chase said something like substituting this equation into that.
No, the equations are only for surfaces.
Wrong. He's so wrong.
Are you really sure?
It's really simple. I'll show you how this works. So basically, you take point A, and then you deduct away point B.
No, it's
really simple. I'll show it to you. So once you're done with that, all you have to do is find part C. And once you're done finding part C, all you have to do is find part D.
Deduct
away part A. And with that, you'll get part B. Isn't that really simple?
No, listen to me, lah. Okay?
Hey, this is library.
That was weird. Anyway, I thought that
Nah, I think you're pretty smart.
Oh.
Maybe I'll do it your way.
Oh, okay. Anyway, I think this homework is gonna take us like such a long time to do.
It's okay, we can do it. And it was kind of funny, because when I suggested the wrong answer for Chase's homework, and I'm pretty sure she already knew the right answer, she reversed back to her original self and yelled at me for being dumb.
Whoa. Guaranteed cuckoo in the head, man.
Well, I thought it was the cutest thing. But afterwards, she realized that she basically broke character and went back to being all Valley Girl.
Huh. You know, maybe she's just trying to impress you. I know a lot of international students who are like that.
But she doesn't have to, though. I thought she was cute the first day. Now I'm just slightly creeped out.
Maybe you just have to give her some space.
Space? What does that even mean?
Like, the next time you meet her, don't be so lovey-dovey and all over her.
But I wasn't.
Please, I know you. On any day, any girl would be lucky enough to get a smile out of you. But I'm sure with her, you're all smiles and long sentences, huh? Yeah. So the next time you meet her, just pretend you're not interested. And then she'll stop trying so hard.
You know what? That sounds pretty good. Maybe I'll try that. But okay, enough about me. What about you?
What about me?
Come on, man. I caught you the other day texting someone and you had the widest grin on your face.
Well, okay, fine. There's this guy, Sam, in my physics class. Mm-hmm. And we started doing physics homework a lot. And yeah, we just hang out a lot. And I guess I just really like spending time with him.
Wait.
Yeah.
Ben.
Yeah?
Are you gay?
I don't know. I mean, maybe he's just a really close friend?
Maybe you do like him.
I mean, I don't know what this is, you know. I've liked girls before.
Wait, Ben.
Yeah?
Is he gay?
I don't know. I mean, could be, but natural sexuality is a thing, right?
Yeah.
So, it's just, you know, I think of him at random moments, you know. Like, I'll see something and I'll be like, oh, somewhere like that.
You know, that's pretty intense.
Shut up. I said I don't know already.
Maybe you could try telling him, you know, how you feel about him.
I just said I don't know how I feel about him.
Just tell him that you care a lot for him, you know, even if he doesn't feel for you the same way. I'm sure he'd be happy to know that you care.
I guess. I mean, there's no harm in doing that, right?
Yeah. Hey, Ben.
Yeah?
I guess we both have our Sam issues, huh?
Whatever. Did you do the question about the D-shaped wire?
Yeah. That was kind of complicated, but I've seen a lot of D's in my time.
Yeah, okay. So do you just consider these two parts as separate?
Yeah, I think you just have to consider the contributions of each part and then sum them up.
Ah, yeah, I think I get it. Thank you.
No problem.
Hey, Sam.
Yeah, Ben?
When's the last time we had dinner together?
I don't know. I think it was like 2 weeks ago?
2 weeks? Huh. Has it already been that long?
I think so. 2 weeks wasn't that long ago, though.
Nah, that's hella long, man. You want to grab dinner tonight?
Tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love that. That's perfect.
Alright, where do you want to go?
Anywhere is fine. You want to check the menus?
Okay. menu.dining.ucla.
Ooh, B plate has Chipotle chicken balls.
Yeah. The lines are always too long for those. Ooh, how about the NEF? They have country fried chicken.
That's so many calories.
Dude, you're fine. And besides, fried chicken is always worth it.
Debatable, but okay. Yeah, the NEF it is.
All right.
You want to meet there at 7?
Yeah, like you always do.
Cool.
Hey Sam.
Yeah, Ben?
You know...
What do I know?
You know, you mean a lot to me, right?
Wait, what?
Yeah, you're like more than just a good friend, you know? Yeah, you're like... You're like a brother. You're like a brother to me.
I feel the same way too. Hey Ben. I just remembered that I have a group project that I have a meeting for, and I gotta go, but I don't know what time it'll end, so I don't think I can make it to dinner.
Wait, but you just said it was perfect.
I know. I thought it was. I'll see you around, Ben.
Wait, Sam, wait, what about tomorrow?
To tell him. And here all I am is his brother? What does that even mean? What did I expect?
believe me, I love you, but I'm not in that way.
At least I did my way. My way to fade. In my mind, I understand. By my hand, I know it was all about you. I feel.
Just submitted our first draft. Then she goes on and says the second draft is due next week. What the hell, man?
I know, right? But I tell you, all my other class are so easy. Just GVs only. I'm doing like oceanography, and my professor gives me so much extra credit, I can just skip the final and still pass.
Pass? Did you just say pass? It's our first quarter here. We gotta aim for that 4.0, man.
Hey, Kai Chen, why are you always so uptight about this? It's fine. C's get degrees. Look at him, man. He knows how to live a life.
Hey guys, you know you guys are here.
Dude, we walk here together, man.
Sorry, I forgot. It's been a crazy night.
Dude, we got here like 3 minutes ago.
Woo! Turn up, guys!
Hey guys, look! Is that Dr. Lisa?
Oh wait, what the hell? What is she doing here?
Who's Dr. Lisa?
Your incomplete professor! Guys, this is kind of awkward. Maybe we should go.
Hey, wait, no. This is our opportunity. We should go and call her up for a friend party. So that side, she can't pick on us first.
No.
No, up or up. Hey, fancy seeing you here, Dr. Lisa.
Yes, Mr. Lichte? Would you like to discuss your second draft with me? Oh, I see you and your friends out here partying tonight. Is it safe for me to assume that your drafts are ready for tomorrow?
I'm going to do it now. Sorry, man.
Good boy. Remember, kids, don't turn it up until you turn it in.
She's also in Math 32A. We were working on a problem set together.
Oh, you didn't ask me to work on it with you?
Oh, I thought you'd be busy. And besides, Alina's really good at math too.
Stop it, Kat. You're embarrassing me.
He got a lot of the parametric stuff wrong. He doesn't realize his mistakes.
Oh wait. Oh, girl, what's your Animation Students Association thing? I almost didn't recognize you. You definitely weren't as well dressed.
Okay, thank you. I really like your outfit too. Where do you get it from? Trader Joe's?
Oh, hey Sam, wait. I didn't realize you were Malaysian too. That's really cool.
Well, of course you wouldn't realize. I mean, look at that. That thick ass valuable accent. Oh!
Wait, maybe she just got Americanized.
Yeah, what are you trying to hide?
I've got nothing to hide, sweetheart. What are you trying to hide underneath all that makeup? Your face? Oh. Kevin, I am leaving.
Alina. I'm sorry, I gotta go. Oh.
This is such a stupid idea. All I did was make such a fool out of myself.
she get drunk, smoke like a birthstone.
Whoa, stop.
Okay. Alright. Good job.
So yeah, I mean, I guess it's kind of like that.
Isn't that just college dating culture in general?
No, dear. It's very different in Malaysia and Singapore.
Really? Like, how?
Yeah, it's not so open, and it's quite hard to even get past the "does he like me" stage. Like, people here ask me, what base you get to? And I'm like, he smiled at me. Is that first base, ah?
Come on, tell me that, man.
Okay, I mean, yeah, it's not bad. It's just complicated. I mean, we're not, like, ignorant or immature. We just, we don't really do, like, the intimate, like, touchy-touchy stuff. And, we don't express emotions that openly. But I guess to elaborate on this...
Wait, don't tell me you have a dance number for this too.
As a matter of fact...
Pretending to be something you're not, and only be with people who like you only because of that, then you really need to take a good hard look at yourself, reevaluate your life choices, and really think about who you even are. Jenny, I gotta go.
Maybe
Greg is a point. I mean, no one should have to pretend to be someone they're not, or be afraid about being open about who they really are. And if anyone tells you otherwise, or makes you feel otherwise, then maybe they're wrong. Chris, I gotta go.
Wait, what? I swear, Tom is such a weirdo sometimes. So what now?
I guess it's the weekend, right? I'll just think about it, lor. Maybe by the next Incom 3 class, I'll have some idea.
Yeah, I think after what Tom said, I might have some thinking of my own to do.
Do you gotta go too?
No. But okay, I'll tell you what happened.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, I had 2 meetings today. On a Saturday. What the hell, man?
It's college life, bro.
No, can't take it anymore.
Oh yeah, I almost forgot. You met Samuel on Wednesday, right? How'd it go? Did you tell him?
I don't think it went very well.
Wait, what? Did you mess up?
Hey. Why are you assuming it's always my fault, huh? But yeah, kind of. I mean, I told him we haven't had dinner in a while, and we're supposed to get dinner tonight. And then I told him how much he meant to me, and he seemed pretty happy about it. But then, he just grabbed his stuff and made up some excuse and ran off. And he hasn't replied my text since then.
Wait, what exactly did you tell him?
I told him how much he meant to me, how he's like more than a friend, how he's like a brother to me.
Wait, hold on. You said that he's like a brother to you?
Yeah.
Was that the last thing you said before he left?
I don't know. Could be. Yeah.
That totally explains it. You just bro-zoned him. That's why you got upset and left.
Bro-zone? Oh.
Yep, that's what happened. Well, of course, the way he reacted showed that, you know, he felt for you more than as a friend or as a brother.
So, what do I do now?
I don't know. You tell me. I think the real question is, what do you really want to do now?
What does that even mean, man?
Well, as I said, he has feelings for you more than as a friend or as a brother. Do you care at all that he feels that way? Do you want to be more than friends? More than brothers?
I'm not sure.
I think you already know. You just have to give it some time.
I guess. But speaking of Sam's, you know, how are things between you and your Sam?
You know, you told me to give her some space, right? That was a bad idea.
Wait, what happened?
I think I might have hurt her.
Wait, what'd you do?
Okay, so I have this other friend, Alina, and she's also Malaysian, right? So Alina and I, we went to this club together, and then we bumped into Sam. So I don't know what happened, but Alina and Sam got into this huge argument, and I tried to put an end to it, and I think I might have fueled the argument.
Why would you do that?
I don't know. Sam looked great that night. I just found out she was Malaysian too, and I blurted everything out. And things got hella awkward. Sam looked really upset. Alina just left. I didn't know what to do. I just left.
Huh. So I guess you messed up more than me, huh? I can't see how you're looking down on me from your moral high horse.
At least I still plan on telling her how I feel. I just need to find a way, you know, to tell her.
and I like her for who she really is.
Yeah, yeah. Isn't there some Malaysian thing coming up? This Malaysian Singaporean culture night? I got fired for it on Room Walk today, man. Maybe you should ask her to go if you know. Show her you like it. She'll know what you mean. You're a smart guy. You'll know what to do.
You know, that sounds like a pretty good plan. Maybe I'll go. Also, it'll be a great break from midterm studying.
Don't get me started, man. And I mean, besides, worst comes to worst, we'll have fun there, right? I heard past year culture nights have been great.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the annual Malaysian and Singaporean Culture Night 2017. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
No! Dan berubah, berubah melingkari, melaksana hasrat hati.
Same ones who still miss their angpaos, their roti canais, and their kuih bahulus. It's not meant to be easy, but foolish as it may seem, don't ever think that you're alone. You'll always find friends across the ocean's blue. You are beautiful, you are loved, and best of all, you are you.
Oh my god, guys! This is the best culture night ever!
Wait, Sam.
Why does he keep running off like that?
I guess I don't have to pretend anymore, right?
You know, you never had to pretend in the first place.
I don't know why, I don't know why I thought that was a good idea. And my friends kept telling me it was a stupid idea. It felt wrong to me too, but I'm sorry you had to deal with that. It must have been quite weird.
Well, it was. But the girl I knew in week one, she was cute, funny, intelligent, and she was real. And from that first glance I shared with you, I felt this crazy feeling. And I wanted it to stay.
I'm not ready. I'm not ready for this. I need to really think about, you know, like who I am and what I really want. I mean, I still like you a lot, but I need to be honest with myself and accept myself for who I am before any of this can happen.
But I told you, I like you for who you really are.
Maybe, but how can you say you like the real me when even I don't really know who the real me is? Yet, I mean, in future, if I'm ready and you haven't found someone else yet, maybe we can give it another shot. But for now, I really need to go my own way.
Okay then.
Hey, it'll be okay.
Wait, Sam.
What do you want, Ben? Look, I said something the other day, and I'm not sure if I was being honest. To you or to myself.
What? So I don't actually mean that much to you? No.
That's the complete opposite of what I mean. Look, I don't know what's going on with me, but maybe now I understand better what's going on with you. You know, it must have been easy coming to LA of all places and still feel like you have to be careful about showing who you really are.
Who I really am? What would you know about that?
Fine, you know, if you're not going to be honest, then I will, because that's what we should do, right? Be honest to ourselves. I've never felt this way about a guy before. And I don't even know what this way is. But I care about you a lot, okay? Way more than a friend. And way more than a brother as well. And I want to understand how I feel about you better.
So, what are you saying?
I'm saying, will you give us a chance?
I don't know.
Please, Sam.
I think you're right. I do need to be honest with myself. And I know I can't try to be with you until you know what you want, because I know who I am, and this isn't good for me.
But I still care about you so much.
I care about you a lot, too. So, maybe when you figure out what you want, let me know. But until then, we'll still be physics homework buddies. Brothers, right? I'll see you around then. Guess things didn't work out, huh?
No. How about you?
Not so well either.
Boys are so dumb.
Agreed.
Not you though.
Obviously. Okay.
Justin, Nick Tay, and Kai Chen as the classmates.
Amanda and Yen Ro as Crystal and Jenny. Darren and Gregory as Tom and Greg.
The main cast, Jeff Lam and Yu Hui Feng as Samuel and Ben. Bibi Tan and Eugene Young as Samantha and Kevin.
Lighting, Desmond, Yizhu, Ray, and Bunsen.
Finally, we have our committee, the choreographers, Winnie. Thank you so much. I hope you had as much fun as we had.